Hey guys, Spider Games here. In this video, I'm going to show you the new Gatling gun in Fallout 76, and I'm also going to show you where you can farm for unlimited mods for weapons, so stick around. So I found this gun in a random duffel bag, which means it was a random spawn. I'm not going to bother showing you the location. It could spawn anywhere, but it has a damage of 30 and a fire rate of 400, making it the fastest Gatling gun we've ever seen. However, when I was firing it, it was the slowest Gatling gun I've ever seen. Now, I don't know if you have to do something special. I was trying to tap A. I don't know why I didn't think of this, but maybe you have to hold down the sprint button and your dude will crank it faster. Maybe your agility needs to be higher or something. I'm not sure. It says 400. That's without mods. If I needed mods, it wouldn't say that the fire rate was 400 as is. But as you can see, it also doesn't have any crosshairs when you look down the sights. Not that it has any sights, but you'd expect something. Maybe that's a mod. But I did break it down for science to see what mods I did get, and I got the best mod you could ever hope for when it comes to this gun. Comfort Grip. Now, let's move on to Big Bend Tunnel East, which is southeast on your map, where all the danger lies. Here you can find nuke codes, weapons galore, and you can find 3 power armor suits and the chassis. I'll show you that in a little bit. But now we're inside the tunnel, and if you follow the tracks, you're going to wind up in an area, which I'll show you in a second. But as you're clearing this area, all you need is a sniper rifle. The sniper rifle is the best weapon you can bring to the tunnels because you can stand far back and just snipe these dudes to death. And you don't have to worry about them reacting most of the time. They just keep standing there like statues. Some of them will react. We are still in the beta phase, so this could change. So keep that in mind, and please have mercy on me. So we've actually made our way to the area where we're going to be accessing the dungeon loot room. But if you've already been here and farmed this and you've seen my previous video, we're just going to go ahead and continue towards what I believe to be Big Bend Tunnel West. I'm not sure if that's what the location is actually called, so sorry if I got that wrong. Doesn't really matter. All we gotta do is keep heading down the tunnel. We're gonna find more scorched enemies, and we're not gonna forget about the dungeon loot. Don't worry, we're gonna go and kill these scorched. Not only are they gonna be carrying weapons, which we can take to workbench and scrap for the mods, woo! But we can also find all the ammo that we ever wanted. So whenever I run out of ammo, I've got like 20 rounds left in my sniper rifle, I head here because I always walk away with like 100 308 rounds and 100 more shotgun shells. I'm getting more ammo than I can actually use, which is why this is my favorite place to go ahead and farm. I know the area very well and it's very easy. But now we want to get into the dungeon loot room, and to do that without having to retrieve the key for the locked door, all we gotta do is hop on these boxes and then onto this container, onto this cute yellow tractor, onto this container here, and then onto this support beam so then we can hop over the handrail there. Now in this area we're gonna find the dungeon loot chest, but we want to get the power armor first, which is in the storage room. And you also get 2 fusion cores. Now here's the dungeon loot chest, which is where I found my 10mm submachine gun. And I hope you guys find something good in here. Sometimes I will get through a dungeon and I just get shit on by, I don't know, the God games or something. Probably just regular God, he hates me. But anyways, this is where we get the key. We just head down this tunnel. We were being very careful, trying to loot everything we could, you know, exploring, but it should just take like 20 seconds to run down to this tractor where you're gonna see this dead body carrying the Big Bend Tunnel door key. And once you grab that for the first time, you're gonna spawn in a bunch of scorched. And we actually got a legendary to spawn in. It spawned in for us, it might not spawn in for you. In Fallout 4, that's how the mechanic worked. You know, legendaries didn't always spawn, they weren't guaranteed, but I hope it does for you. But anyways, I found just a regular shotgun with no legendary effect. I thought there's a, because of the snappy part, I thought it had a legendary effect. I don't know why I didn't notice it didn't have a damn star. Anyways, our second power armor suit is going to be on the power armor stands at the entrance. It might be empty for you, But anyways, in my previous video, I showed you guys where to find 12 power armors, and they are represented by the little stars. And the ones that are numbered, besides the one on the far right, there's three numbers there that don't go to anything. But those numbers I just showed you are power armor locations that I know of where I'm going to go explore today. Today is November 4th, the last day of the beta that we know of. So I'm going to locate these power armors and hopefully put out a video tonight or tomorrow night. So that's about it, guys. I just wanted to let you know what I'm doing with the power armor. I'm still going to do that series. I'm going to locate all these things. I'm not calling it all power armor locations for nothing. I'm going to find them all. But yeah, guys, I hope you found this informative. I hope you learned something, and I hope you enjoyed it most of all. And if you did, please leave a like. That helps my videos out a lot. I recently started to ask for those, and it feels kind of weird and stupid, but I'm going to do it anyways. And also, subscribe for future videos like the power armor stuff. I know you guys are going to want that. I did make a poll, and I asked you guys what you wanted more, and you guys wanted to know the locations of all the power armors, so I'm going to do that. But yeah, guys, that's it. I'm fighting a Scorched here, and we are actually in a weird location I'm going to cover in a future video. And basically, we had this dude basically cheated. We cheated because he can't crawl down the tunnel towards us. But anyways, I'll cover that in another video. Thanks, guys, for watching, and as always, I will see you in the next video.